So we got x equals 4, and we're going to plug it into somewhere up here. There we go. That series as a box around it. So we got 4. I'm just looking over here. 4 minus 2 is 2 to the n. So 4 minus 2 is 2, which will cancel out. That term cancels the n. And that's some real quick cancellation right there. So that whole thing is 2 to the n. Reduce, and then on the bottom we have n 2s and then another 2. So n of them we're going to cancel out, and we'll be left with a single 2. Converge or diverge? No, you gotta, there's no neither. It's not an option. Can't be neutral. Because what does it mean to diverge? It means you don't converge. So you can't both converge and not converge. So it either converges or diverges. So some of you are right, some of you are wrong. We got to figure out why is it going to do one of those two. So it's alternate. So I could try alternating series. The question is, do the other two conditions get satisfied, which is the terms get smaller? They don't really get smaller. They're a half, negative a half, half, negative a half. There is one test I could very easily apply. Probably could do ratio test. How about nth term test for divergence? If the terms don't get small, if they don't go toward zero, this does not converge automatically. So these terms go towards a half or negative a half. They're never going to go to zero. Because this 2 on the bottom, this is not 2 to the n anymore. So it's not going to keep getting smaller. So the nth term test, you take a limit of just the term, which is very clearly not zero. It actually does not exist, because it goes between negative one-half and positive one-half. So it does not exist, but specifically it's not zero, which is as long as your nth term doesn't go towards zero, you're going to diverge. So if you got a friend in Calc 2, they may have their convergence-divergence tests written out really nicely on their cheat sheet. So you can either find somebody in Calc 2 who you trust, or find your old cheat sheet from Calc 2 and rewrite the convergence-divergence test section. All right, so we got the sequence diverges. So 4 is out. 2 is out. Well, I should say 0 is out. So we get everything between 0 and 4. So our interval of convergence is 0 to 4. So that is our review of sequences and series converging, diverging. There's plenty of other problems I could do, but we need to move on. So now we're going to look at how to solve a linear. It doesn't have to be linear. So a solution to an ODE by series methods. So this theorem is starts out with an ODE, nth degree. So first thing I notice, this does not need to be linear. What does linear mean? Linear would mean all these f functions are constants. They'd be all constant. So this works for non-linear.
Does the first term get a coefficient too?
If it had one, you would divide everything by that. So if it was, I could use a fn maybe. So I just divide everything by fn. Which would also mean if that was ever zero, I would not have a valid solution whenever. I'd be divided by zero, basically.
Right.
All right, so this is our setup. Doesn't need to be linear. So we need some conditions. These coefficient functions need to have some properties. So if each fn minus 1, fn minus 2, down to f1 and f0,